We're coming up on the 5th anniversary of our first certification, and I speak to that as one aspect of what we do at CrossFit, because I think it's very telling of the entire movement in that, again, we didn't plan any of this. And what had happened was that October or November of 2002, I got a call from some guys at University of Southern Mississippi working for the National Police Corps. And the deal was, is a guy, Charlie Sims, on the phone, older fella. And he said, I want to come out and get certified in y'all's program. And I told him, sir, we don't have a certification. And he wasn't having it. He says, you don't understand. I'm going to come out, and we're going to get certified, and that's why I'm calling you. Two guys came out. And we had five trainers and four or five witnesses and a handful of onlookers. And we hammered these guys for 2 days. We showed them everything. Fran, Helen, Elizabeth, Diane, they got on the Bacar ladder, on the rings. It was entirely unprofessional, and it's a miracle. Thank God we didn't kill them both. But we showed them everything we knew. Our line was that we put these guys back on the airplane with a spatula. I mean, they were toast. It was over. And I got one of these guys here today, one of the first two CrossFitters, Ted Socia. Come on up, Ted.
What happened originally is some guys from Jacksonville were at a leadership school I attended. They're doing this crazy run a mile, bench press your body weight 21 times, and swim 500 meters, and every 50 meters do 50 push-ups, and on and on, and throw up, and so on and so forth. And in a few life-threatening situations, and I know what that does to you physiologically, and I was getting those feelings from this stimulus. You do Fran, and it's a lot like being in a fight for your life if you do it to your absolute maximum potential. So when Chief Obrey told me to find this guy, this Coach Glassman, find him and let's get this thing together, and let's make a combat fitness program for this police corps, unlike any of the other programs that were out there for academy training, which was, you know, basically run, push-ups, pull-ups, sit-ups, and stretching, a little low course, and that's about it. So we said, yeah, we'll do it. And Chief Sims called Coach Glassman, and they talked for a while. I think me and Coach talked for a while, and I got out there expecting the basic, you know, Cooper type thing. You know, where you go out there, here's your manual, learn it, whatever. No. They started off the bat with Tabata this, or they didn't call it Tabata this. They said, I'll show you about this Izumi Tabata guy. Came up with this interval protocol, and he was going to do this, and we're going to da 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 da, and smoke like I haven't felt in forever. And it truly changed. It was a life-changing experience. And so we brought that back to police corps, and we started, which was already going on in Jacksonville, through TJ Cooper, and that's how I met Billy Perry, a good friend of mine, who was doing this stuff at the leadership school, and that just kind of brings it forward. And we did need a certification because the state didn't want you to teach anything unless you had a cert for it. So we called him and said, hey, can you give us a cert? And he said, well, yeah, I guess I can. And came out there, smoked us all day, you know, two or three workouts a day, done to our maximum, and then a big ream of research at night. Now read that, and we'll talk about it tomorrow. And he was saying things that you know, it should have occurred to me. It should have occurred to all of us, and it did. It's just an amazing experience. And the things I can do now that I could never do then, that is the difference. Furthermore, the things that I'm able to teach people and the potentials that they can reach and the limits that they thought they had weren't limits at all, those things will make you feel good inside. I mean, it's what it's all about. helping people survive that life-threatening situation. And that's what it is for me. It can be whatever it is for every, you know, each individual person, but for me, it is survival in that ultimate moment when it's you or them. And that's what this response is. This thing, it listens, and it's tremendous.